Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to create a multi-layered white bar transition in After Effects. So first, move your clips to the beat markers and then cut off the remaining bits. Now pre-compose each of your clips individually by using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+Shift+C or Cmd+Shift+C on Mac and click OK. Then open up each of the pre-comps, right-click a blank area and click Composition Settings, and set the height to 1/4 of this value, which in my case is 400. Now click S to open up Scale Properties, and scale down the clip and position it to the center of your frame. If the clip doesn't fill the screen completely and leave some black bars behind, then drag on the Motion Tile effect, and set the output height and output width to 400 and click Mirror Edges. Then do the same for the rest of your pre-comps. Once you've done that, apply the Twixter Pro effect to one of your pre-comps and copy my settings. Now copy paste the effect to all your other pre-comps. Now click on the first pre-comp, click the align panel and align it to the top. Then open the position keyframes on all of them and add 400 to the previous one. So 600 for this one, 1000 for this one, and 1400 for this one. Once you've arranged these clips, create a new shape layer and cut it at all these points. Click on the pen tool and draw a line here. Make sure you hold down Shift to make sure that the line is straight, and set the stroke to something like 50. Do the same for the rest of the clips. Extend these shaped layers so that they fill the entire composition. Now create a new solid layer and make sure the height is set to 400 and click OK. Cut the solid layer at each of these points. Match the position to the clips below them. So for this one, set it to 200, like this clip. For this one, set it to 600. This one, 1000. And the final one, set it to 1400. Now go 3 frames after your first solid. Click T to open up opacity keyframes and create a keyframe. Then go 3 frames before the end and set the opacity to 0. Now copy and paste these keyframes onto the rest of your white solid. Pre-compose these white solids and apply the deep glow effect. Also apply the deep glow effect to these shape layers. Set the radius to 150 and the exposure to 0.15 and copy and paste it to the other shape layers. Now the animation should look like this. Now we want to create the 3D camera animation. So create a new camera layer and select these settings. Click OK. Now create a new null object and parent the camera layer by using this pickwick tool to the null object. Then click toggle switches and modes and toggle 3D on all of these layers. Also toggle motion blur. Click P to open up position keyframes and create one at the end and one at the start. Disable the white solid pre-comp layer and increase the Z and decrease the Y values until the clip perfectly fits in frame. Once Once you've done that, select all the keyframes, click F9 to easy ease them, and open the graph editor. Make sure you have speed graph selected, and set the influence to 0, and the influence to 100 over here. Your animation should then look like this. Anyway, that's it for today's video. See you in the next one.